John King for the Sprawl, post-fight at Cage Warriors 78, alongside Dylan McLoughlin and Adam Ventry, who's being sick in a sink. Dylan, I've been promising you all week, if you win, or even if you lose, you get Oreos. There you go. Firstly, I want to ask you, what's in the hamper? You get to eat now, what's in your hamper?
Okay, we've got red velvet Oreos, cinnamon bun Oreos, we've got these thotted shortcake, little caramel things looking good, Reese's peanut butter cups, I think that's it for now, but these are getting added to the hamper. And I'm gonna get fat because I'm ugly.
That's not bad. Let's talk about the fight. Came in, you're using kicks, kind of striking for a little bit, and you were landing good shots, and then you exchanged punches. You had your back against the cage, got caught, ended up on your back, and you know, from that point on, it kind of looked like the fight was over. You were getting lit up, you were getting hit with every single shot he threw. It looked like the ref was gonna step in. In that moment, what were you thinking?
This is heavy. I was thinking I need to do something here, but he was catching it. To be honest, he wasn't even heavy handed. He just caught me with that one good shot, and I was like, oh my god, I wasn't even wobbled. It was just my nose was fucking killing.
Yeah,
and I was like, all right, I need to do something here. So I just thought, fuck it, take that.
Yeah.
And then from there, we moved straight into the mouth and just started pounding him.
Yeah. Do you think, go on.
He just had nothing for me there.
Yeah. Do you think your nose is broken?
Probably, like, am I that ugly?
A little bit.
You tell me. Your shoulder's fucked as well, like.
How did you do that, you know?
Can't even remember, lad.
Do you know what's wrong with it?
Nah, it's just sore, you know. I can't even lift it, though.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to spend my night in the Aussie now. My bird thinks she's going on a night out with me now, it's not happening.
are you disappointed in the performance, or is it just a case of, like, you know, you got caught, it's the fight game?
It's not really to be disappointed over, is it? Because I got the win at the end of the day.
Yeah.
I'm still 3-0, I'm still undefeated, so I'm not even arsed, lad. I'm just gutted that I'll probably be out for a bit with this nose now for the rest of the year and my sore shoulder.
Yeah.
So I was looking to fight again before the year end, but hopefully that impressed Cage Warriors, because I fight like that every time. if my back gets put against the fence, I'm never out to fight me.
Yeah.
Never. So you can expect a fight like that every time if shit hits the fan, like.
Yeah, you told me before, and you know, you were kind of going to feel him out in the striking game, and if he wants to go for a takedown, you go for it. What was the actual game plan coming into this?
Do whatever, really, whatever comes, do you know what I mean? Like, if the takedown was there, take the takedown. If it was to stand with him, I was going to strike with him, but I felt good, I come out and I felt good. I was like, okay, I've got me raised down with this kid. I was picking him with shots and that. He hit me with a few, but they never hit, so I was like, okay. And I was landing more than him, hit him with the head kick and that, buckled him a little bit. And I was like, okay, I've got this, and then fuck off. Stick me with some massive left hook on the nose.
Yeah.
Okay. Gets rough from here.
Yeah. Did you kind of know as soon as you got to take down, you like Oreos, as soon as you got to take down, you transitioned straight into the mount, did you know that the fight was over from there?
As soon as I got that mount, my nose was fucking killing, and I could just see blood pouring out of it, so I just thought, fuck it, just carry on whacking him until the ref pulls me off him. I could hear my corner screaming, whack him,
yeah.
Keep pounding him until it's over, so that's what happened.
Yeah. Did you think at any point when you were here, do you think that the ref was kind of going to step in?
Yeah, I could hear him saying, fucking, you do something and that. And I was thinking, shit, I'm going to get stopped here. What's happening? Do you know what I mean? And then I just shot in. Like, I think I threw a few windmills back just to let him know that I was still in the fight.
Yeah.
And then as soon as I shot in, I moved straight into mount, and it was over from there. I knew I'd tearing him on the floor, so. It's one of them, isn't it?
Yeah. I'll let you go quickly and let you sit down. Anybody you'd like to give a shout out to before you go?
Everyone who's helped me through this camp, you know. Fucking Paul, especially, put a bit of time into me. All the boys, Ellis, Paddy. Ellis has just lit his man up, by the way, so well done, El. Connor, fucking Harry. Adam, both the Adams, everyone who's been there, you know, Paddy, We've all bounced off each other. Leroy Barnes has been getting it as well. Big shout out to Leroy because he's been a good training partner. And everyone back home and stuff, he believes in me.
Yeah.
So that crowd is what pulled me through that fight there. I wasn't about to go down in front of that crowd, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not going down in front of no crowd. Fucking hit me with a steel chair, I'll still stand in front of you. So,
yeah, Dylan, thank you very much, and congratulations. Thanks, hopefully, we see you next time.